Now, here is the creative path on your screen. The first step is you need to have an idea, right? Once you have an idea, that leads to the approach or the process. And because of the approach, then finally you will have the book. So just three steps: idea, approach, and the book. Now, what is an idea? How do you get an idea for a book? Now, idea could be just a basic thought that has been in your mind for a while, something that is bothering you, something that you would like to think about or explore through a story. That could be an idea. Idea could be an experience. Maybe you've gone through some very difficult time, or someone that you know has gone through a very difficult time and has shared that experience with you. That experience becomes an idea. Idea could also be a character. Sometimes you will come across very interesting or very unusual, very different kind of people. And I'm sure you must have wondered at some point that what will happen if I pick this person and put this person in a situation with dramatic twist and dramatic changes, how will this person react to those changes in a story around him? Sometimes it is not just actual person around you, but maybe a story that you've read in a newspaper of someone who's caught in a particular situation and you are left wondering what happens thereafter. So once again, ideas could come from anywhere, any of these three things. It could just be a thought, it could be an experience, or it could be a character. Now, once you've got the idea, you can go to the next step. But before we go there, I want to give you an example of the idea that I had about one of my recent novels, Murder in Paharganj. Now, Murder in Paharganj is one of my very popular and successful novels. And when I was writing that book, even before writing, my idea was very simple. I wanted to write an espionage novel that involves a young man, an espionage novel that involves a young man in deep trouble, and what happens to him after he gets into even deeper trouble. So I started the story with a character who's got three problems. He is someone who has lost his job. That's a big problem for a young man. He is someone who had a girlfriend and his girlfriend has left him. So that is, again, he's in deeper trouble. And the third thing is, because of not having a job and girlfriend leaving him, he's become an alcoholic. So he's got these three major problems and he's at the lowest point of his life. Now, I was just thinking that, okay, this is how I want to begin my story. This is my story idea. But the story idea further was that what happens to this man if he gets into even more trouble? So what I did for the purpose of this story is that right in the beginning, everyone starts thinking that he is a killer. So there is a murder and he reports that murder. And without his knowing, everyone implicates him, particularly the police, and labels him a killer. Now, in the story is all about his trying to prove his innocence. That is the story, right? So if you have an idea of this kind that is sitting on your conscience for a long time and you just want to explore that idea, as I said, it could be just a thought like it happened to me, or it could be an experience or a character, then that is a perfect recipe. First step accomplished, right? Now you have to go to the second step. Now, second step is the approach, or the process, as I said. So approach are, again, very, very simple. I'll make it very simple for you. So there are basically only two kinds of approaches. The first approach is the structured approach, and the second approach is unstructured approach. So structured approach is something when you actually plan out your novel, which is also known as plotting your novel. So you have a plot. An unstructured approach is you have an idea and you just take that idea forward. You start just writing. Now, let me go back to Murder in Paharganj. For that, I wanted to adopt the structured approach. So what I did, I expanded that into a plot of about 2000 words. And once I was satisfied with that plot, I thought, okay, now let me go into the writing phase. And that is how I wrote this novel. I could have done other way around also. From idea, I could have straight away started writing, and with the characters and the situation taking me in different directions, I would have probably had a story. So these are the two approaches. Now, let me make it more clear to you. A step-by-step method to approach an idea. And once you listen me out here, it'll be very clear to you. So the first step is idea. The second step is, now the idea which was there in your mind, you need to write it down somewhere on your computer or piece of paper, wherever. You write that idea and let that idea stay there and build on that idea over a period of time. You refine that idea. You keep thinking about that idea, and automatically you will realize that idea will get refined. And when you are sure that this is your idea, you take one of the approaches, structured or unstructured. Now let us see what happens if you take structured approach. Now in structured approach, now from idea, you have to pick your main character and give a conflict to the main character and at least two or three major twists, right? So keeping that in mind, you expand the idea into a paragraph plot, right? You look over that plot again and again, keep thinking about it till the time you feel comfortable and you think that actually that is a nice and clear expansion of your original idea. Once you reach to that stage, then you start giving it an ending, start thinking about the beginning, and start thinking about what is going to happen in the middle. And in doing so, you expand it to, let's say, about 2000 words. Now this 2000 words will actually capture your entire story, and this will be basically your structured approach and your plot. Now this is basically your plan, right? So your idea has been converted into plan by the structured approach method. Now this plan is something that you need to follow to write your entire novel. Now the beauty about the system is that you need not stick to this plan. Why? In the process of writing it down, I had briefly brought it to your attention when I was speaking about plot as well, and I'm repeating it here. You start writing, and while writing, if you feel that there is a requirement for you to change the plot slightly, you're welcome to do that, because it is, after all, your book. But you have a kind of a blueprint and you try to follow that blueprint. Now let us try to see what happens in an unstructured plot. Approach. In unstructured approach, from the idea stage, you just start writing. So you got an idea, step one. Step two is you write it down, you refine over a period of time, you're comfortable with your idea, and after that, straight away start writing. Now it might appear to you that how do you do that? You just don't know what's going to happen in the story. But trust me, I would say about 60 to 70% writers that I meet, wherever I meet them, they are more comfortable with the unstructured approach, because they feel that they would like to discover the story themselves, and they find it more fun to discover the story rather than knowing what is going to happen in the story beforehand, and they don't enjoy the process. So I don't know which one will work for you, but for me, the structured approach works better. And in a creative writing class, since we are doing that, I must say that you try to follow a structured approach, at least in the beginning of your career. If it is still not clear, let me try to explain to you in another way. Now let's say at evening 7 o'clock, there is a man, he calls his wife and says that I've got 5 friends coming for dinner. And what will the wife say? Obviously she'll say that she'll not be happy with this information, and she'll say that you should have informed me earlier, I'm not prepared. But he says there is no choice, and the friends are already on their way, and we have to make use of whatever time is available. So both of them, they get together, they start sorting the living room, they start planning the dinner, they start calling whatever snacks can be brought from outside, etc. And it becomes an impromptu plan. There is no plan, and they just start doing it, and in between the friends also come. Now by the end of this party, let's say the party finishes at midnight, there could be two outcomes. One outcome could be that the party was a disaster, right? Nothing was available, that there was no ice, there was no food properly, the seating was not okay, and it was a disaster, both of them might think. Or it might turn out to be a great, wonderful party because it was impromptu. So sometimes when you don't have a plan, it comes out very well. But there is always a risk of ruining the whole thing. So I would recommend that have a structure. But both the forms actually work very well depending on the temperament of the writers. Are you ready for the quiz time? So here's the question. For both the structured and the unstructured approach, what is the crucial ingredient required to start writing a novel? Answer in the comment section below. One lucky winner would receive an exciting Internshala trainings merchandise. Hope you enjoyed learning how to convert your ideas into impactful novels. This video is a part of Internshala trainings creative writing program. And to learn creative writing from scratch, visit the link in the description. To learn exciting new concepts and skills on the go, subscribe to our channel and click on the bell icon to stay tuned.